Today, we're going to explore how function calling works in a detailed way. We'll start with an easy example of a chat completion from OpenAI, and then we'll add our own methods to make it more interesting, like one that tells jokes. After that, we'll introduce a more complex function that gives weather updates for a specific place, which needs an extra piece of information or argument. Later on, we'll reveal how all of this is similar to what Autogen does. You'll be surprised to see how quickly we can get close to the way Autogen equips agents with the ability to call functions. First, as usual, we create a virtual environment to clearly separate the project's dependencies. Next, we import OS for using environment variables, JSON for passing arguments, and OpenAI for making requests to the OpenAI API. For this purpose, we need to install OpenAI by running the command pip install OpenAI. We'll start with a basic example of the chat completion API. To do this, we first create an OpenAI client, which only needs an API key for initialization obtained from the environment variables. Then we can go ahead and set up our first chat completion request. For this, we call the chat completion create function on the client and pass the necessary messages to it. Our first task is to prompt the system to just say hello. For the model, we select GPT 3.5 Turbo, which is not the most powerful but is currently the fastest. The result we're aiming for is actually found under the Choices section, the first entry, and we have the result displayed for us. It looks good so far. We received a friendly hello as a response, so we can proceed from here. The next step will be to add a first function. For this, we will create a tool definition that makes functions accessible to OpenAI. I have prepared this in advance to avoid potential typing errors I might make. We observe that it's a straightforward function returning a joke of the day and doesn't use any parameters. Before applying it, I'd like to modify the prompt to generate a joke without assigning the tool. We observe that we receive GPT's standard joke. However, the downside is that if we run it again, we get the exact same joke. This could be altered, but for this example, we intentionally want to link a function that could later retrieve jokes through an API. For this, we now provide it with the tools, and we get a completely different result. In fact, it now suggests that we should use the joke of the day function without any arguments. This implies that OpenAI can choose a function call for us based on the prompt. The question now is how we can deduce the actual functions from this selection of function calls. First, we retrieve the function's name, which we find under tool call function name, and we get the arguments, which are located under tool call function arguments. However, there is a special requirement here. We would like these data in JSON format to pass them to the actual functions, not as a string. In the next step, we need something that allows us to deduce the actual function from the function names. And here's what we can do. We create a mapping where the name of each function is assigned. We call this function map. As we see, the names of the functions are the keys and the functions themselves are the values. Now, of course, we need the actual function. We will initially fill this with a simple dummy by just returning the string random joke of the day. Later, this can be wonderfully supplemented by a call to an API or a library that actually returns jokes. What we can do is this. We can now retrieve the actual function from the functions map using the function name. And then, of course, we can simply call it and pass the parsed arguments to it. Now, let's see if everything works. Cross our fingers. And we see, unfortunately, it does not work. There is a typo somewhere. And I can see that in line 37, we accidentally wrote JSON load. We correct it and try again and again, unfortunately nothing, but this is easy to clarify. In the definition, we said it takes an argument, but we did not do so in the actual method. And when we fix this, we see that we get the string random joke of the day back, just as we want it. Good, now we want to add a second function that does something completely different. Simply to show that it should not be limited to just one function. We add another function that gives us the weather for a specific region. This example is a bit more complex since it takes a location argument. Now, of course, we need to implement the method again. We keep it simple and just return a string. The special thing here is that we get the location from the arguments, which we then also return in the result. Let's add the method to the function map, and then it should be available both as a possible return value for OpenAI, and so that it can actually be executed in our Python code. And we just try it out, first with our old prompt. And we continue to get the bit back. But if we now change the prompt to, for example, what the weather is like in Berlin, I hope to get a different result. And we get, it is hot in Berlin. Wonderful, that works. Now you can imagine that in a conversation with OpenAI, based on the questions you ask, different methods can be called. And now let's take a look at how Autogen actually does this, and we'll recognize a few similarities. I was heavily inspired by Autogen for this example, and we go into the Conversable Agent class to look for the part responsible for executing functions, the execute function method, and if we scroll down a bit, it looks very similar. We have a function name that is determined based on the return result from OpenAI. Let's compare it with our implementation. It's very, very similar. We also have a function map where the function is returned based on this name, and we also have the arguments that are parsed using JSON loads, and ultimately, we execute it by calling the function with the appropriate arguments. This means the magic behind Autogen, how it can autonomously execute functions that were previously declared, is not so magical after all. I hope you enjoyed this little foray into function calling, and if you liked the video, the author would of course appreciate a like.